for my sexuality or a perceived of it. I was not the only one going through this. My friends were subject to vile homophobic attacks as well. At the age of 18, growing up in a country like Nigeria, we had no language, no lexicon, no role models, no understanding, and more importantly, no self-awareness of who we are. However, while we hate the haters, we never thought they were being horrible to us. We thought they were helping us to be normal in a community and a country where normal is heterosexual. To put this in perspective, we were growing up in the 80s and 90s in a country like Nigeria, a time when in the UK, the LGBT community were still struggling and fighting for diversity. However, at 18, I discovered two things that changed my life completely. First was Mariah Carey. And I know it may sound like a cliche, but hey guys, it's Mariah. But also, I discovered the power of music through Mariah when I listened for the first time to Hero. All I wanted was a hero, one that we speak with, for, and to me. However, in the wilderness I find myself, I knew it would only be a fairy tale, or gays. You know, who says a little gay boy can dream? Then something has happened in the same 1993. I discovered the gay community. I went to my first gay party in the underground gay world of Lagos. And I heard songs like, I'm coming out, and I'm every woman. Then I decided that it is time I become the hero I longed for. Music became my friend. While my husband dreaded my singing because of my shameless tone deafness, I have found myself and my pride in music. Tonight, you will listen to many songs. Some will make you laugh, some will make you cry. As I know the London Gay Men Chorus don't disappoint. But as you listen tonight, remember that 50 years ago, songs were the engine oil of the liberation. Songs, protest, chant, and determination has brought us this far. And as we look forward to a more challenging future, with the results of the last election, and the determination by this government to go into a deal with a political party that hates LGBT people, hates immigrants, hates people living with HIV, hates women, hates the disabled, denies climate change, and supports terrorism, let us remember we need the power of music more than ever before. Not just for us, but for all young people, irrespective of sexuality, gender identity, race, religion, creed, political affiliation, immigration status, economic class, or HIV status. Let us also remember that tonight in 78 countries in the world where it is still illegal to be LGBT, the 5 countries where you could be killed for being one. And on a selfish note, my back country, Nigeria, where getting into a same-sex marriage will land you in jail for 14 years. To the London Gay Men Chorus, to Dan and to Simon, I want to say thank you so much for having me tonight. And if you ever need a tone-deaf singer, I'll be very happy to join the queue. To everyone else, but more importantly, to Martin Gordon, I met Martin a few months ago, who was part of the thing Against the Law. As a young man, he was at the forefront of gay sex criminalization in this country. Martin, you are a legend. Thank you so very much. To everyone else, please sit back and enjoy one of the most beautiful camp music of your life. Happy Pride Month, Happy 50th anniversary of decriminalization of gay sex, and thank you. Thank you.